used to, they can really stop. I've never seen a car stop at that.
And again, they're going upwards of 190 miles an hour through the trial. You see where that car got up into the air and into the catch fence. And as you mentioned, it came to a stop right there.
So the fence is pulled away, but the cabling, the horizontal cabling is still intact. We try to keep the car, any large pieces of the car, on the racing surface and out of the stands or the walkway area there.
There is the engine.
Incredible.
And what an incredible sight to see the thumbs going up from the crew members that were checking on Austin, and then Austin Dillon to walk away from that accident. Safety crews continue to check on all of the drivers that were involved in this incident. Let's take another look. Dale Earnhardt Jr. crossing the start-finish line, winning the race, but then the accident takes place behind him.
Yeah, the 11 gets kind of stuck in the middle there and comes across the Ford's bumper. As he does, he spins back in, gets the free airborne, and he just gets projected off the other cars right up into the fence.
He went from the bottom of the racetrack over two rows of cars and into that catch fence.
We're getting the same on the bottom. The next starts in front. He runs in the back of 24. Gets up on the 11. Now he's on top of the 54-5. Now it's just a long garage. Watch the car stop. Watch the car stop. It gets under those poles, and it goes from, I don't know, what, 180, 190 miles an hour, I'm just guessing, to a complete stop. That is unbelievable.
And it looks like that's 3,500 pounds. That stock car is extremely heavy. You see here, after he's upside down, the two is spinning. Obviously, he's already lost control, makes more contact with the three.
Thank you.